Hello Python programmers, this is AK. In this video, we are going to learn about how to automate the Google Maps website using Selenium. If you are new to this video, kindly check the previous automation video that is present in our channel. By watching that videos, you will get more clarification or knowledge about Selenium library. Let's start this video. First, we need to import the required libraries to perform this automation process. Our requirements are Selenium, Chrome Web Driver, and Time Library. These are the requirements to do this job. After importing all the requirements, you need to create a variable called driver. And in this variable, you need to give your installation path of Chrome Web Driver. Then you need to get the Google Maps website. So write driver.get. Inside the brackets, you need to mention your website name. So this is the primary step of all Selenium automation projects. Next, we need to concentrate on searching the places in that Google Maps website. Create a function called searchPlace, and in this function, declare a variable called place. And inside this variable, write driver.findElement by class name. After this step, we need to open the Chrome and search Google Maps. Now you can see the Google Maps website, and in this website, there is a search bar that is present in the web page. Go to the search bar and right click on that and again press the inspect option. Now you can see all the elements in the Google Maps website. For giving the search input through automation process, we need some web elements from the website. That is the protocol of Selenium library. Now look at the web elements in the website. Here you can see the tactile search box input. This is the required web element that we want. So copy that element and paste the element in our place variable. Next, we need to send the input word to the website. So write place.sendKeys. Inside the brackets, you need to mention your destination place. And the next step is, we need to click the search button to process our input. Follow the same process that we did in the previous step. Go to the website and click the search button. Now inspect the button to fetch the web element and copy the web element by XPath. Now in the function, we need to create variable called as submit, and in this variable, you need to paste the XPath value of your element that you copied from the website. We successfully did the first part of automation, and next you need to give another place to find out the kilometers in between our starting point and destination point. Additionally, we are going to find out a few things, that is how many hours to reach the destination and what are the possible ways to reach that destination place. So this is the agenda of this video. Let's write a code for these conditions. Create a function called as directions, and in this function, you need to declare a variable called as directions. Inside this variable, you need to find a web element. So go to the Maps website and you can see the directions button. Inspect the button and copy the XPath value. We are going to send a click to the directions button. So write directions.click. And this is enough for this function. Next, create another function that is named as find. Go to your Maps website and now you can see that this website is asking for the starting point. It's the time to give the starting point. You need to give the starting point, but not manually. We need to give the input through the automations. This is the main role of automations. Go to the search box and inspect the field and copy the web element XPath value. Now we have the web element value for the search box. Here you need to give another place that is our starting point. Write find.sendKeys. And inside the brackets, you need to mention your starting point. After completing these steps, we have two places. The first place that we are given is our destination, and the second place that we are given is our starting point. Next, we need to process the search by clicking the search button. So this is the same process that we did in the previous part of automation. So follow my moves carefully. After fetching the value of the search button, we need to send a click for that button to process the given search inputs. So write send.click. This is the process of automation. And wait, our process is not complete. We need to get how many kilometers between these two places. Here we can apply the flip scraping technique to fetch that results. Create a function called as kilometers, and in this function, you need to put your web element. Go to the website and you can see how many hours to reach the place by bus and train transport medium. We need these values to print our output screen. So follow the same process that we did in the previous step. Here I scrap the data from the Google Maps website and print those data in my telnet. At the end of this script, you will notice how cool it is. So we finished all the steps. Go to your terminal and enjoy the automation process of Selenium library.